Are you having trouble with acceleration not available for Direct3D or DirectDraw not available on Windows? Well, in this video, we're going to show you a solution to that. For a more in-depth look at the problem, be sure to check out the article we link in the description. Let's start by seeing if acceleration. To check this, open a Run dialog box. Press Windows and R. Type in DXDIAG. And click OK. This will open the DirectX diagnostic tool. From the list of tabs on the top, select Display. Here, under DirectX features, you'll find both Direct3D acceleration and DirectDraw acceleration. Check if it says available next to them. If it does not say enabled, then we need to enable it. To do this, open Settings. In System, go to Display. Look for Graphics. Under Default Settings, click on Change Default Graphics Settings. You'll see Hardware Accelerated GPU Scheduling. You'll see an On-Off button and toggle it from Off to On. You'll need to restart your PC to have the changes take effect. To check it that it's on now, go to a Run box. Type in DXDIAG, click OK, go back to Display, and the DirectDraw acceleration and Direct3D acceleration should now say enabled. Next, you can see if a third-party application is interfering with it running properly. Now, sometimes a third-party application can interfere with things like this. To find out if this is the case, you'll have to start your system in a clean boot state with the minimum programs running. Then, if acceleration is working, you know this is the issue. You can then turn on programs one at a time to see which one is the culprit. We did a video on how to start in a clean boot state, and we'll link to it in the description. Finally, we can try and enable legacy DirectPlay from the control panel. Open the control panel, select Programs, then select Programs and Features. You'll find a button on the left, Turn Windows Features On or Off. Click on it, locate Legacy Components, and expand it. View DirectPlay. If it's unchecked, then check it, then click on OK, restart your system, and check and see if it's working then. For more helpful articles to help you maximize your Windows experience, go to our website, thewindowsclub.com. Do not forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, where we are always adding new content aimed at making you the master of your digital house. Thanks for watching, and have a great day.